So let's go back and start again. Well, as I told you before, of course, we can always prepare ourselves to that, but at the end, when we are in the here and now, well, of course, now we have two different heres. One now, but two different heres, right? And this is one of the elements of what we will be talking about, no? Two different heres and one now. I can and have to improvise. So I don't have any written questions about what I'm going to ask you. Do you have a question for me, by the way?
I don't have question, but when you say that we have two heres, it is true that we are in two different locations. I'm in Dallas and you are in
São Paulo.
But in psychodrama, we can imagine whatever we want, and we can, if we can just imagine that actually, technically, we are in the same Zoom meeting. So that is a special magical space where we both are there. So it is also one here.
Okay, but Daniela, when you talk about Zoom, I would see this Zoom. What is this Zoom we are talking about?
So the whole world, people can be anywhere in their homes, anywhere around the world. And they come to this meeting, mm-hmm. and they're together, and distance doesn't exist anymore.
Okay, we have what is Zoom? Zoom is a company, right?
Oh, so it is the official name is Zoom video conferencing.
Uh-huh. What's that?
What is that? So the creator of Zoom, he was a young student in China, and he was traveling 10 hours every week to go to see his girlfriend. And being on the train, he was imagining, what if I could create something so that we can see each other and talk, but I don't have to travel all those hours. Mm-hmm. And then he came to the United States. It was very challenging. He applied 9 times for visa and 8 times he couldn't receive visa because of he was told that his English wasn't good enough. So finally, he came to the United States and he started working for a big computer company. And after a certain time, he created this new program about people meeting together, seeing mm-hmm. each other. And so he proposed this program to this big company, but they refused to see it. So that is when he resigned and he started his own company, Zoom Video Conferencing. He started at first, that was in 2013. He started as a small, very small, small company, and only few people were able at first to meet at the same time. And over time, it was developed to what is today, when hundreds of people can meet.
Okay,
see each other, talk to each other.
Okay, of course, we are not here doing any publicity to Zoom. It's not the issue.
We are not. No. I'm just, it's fascinating.
I can tell you from my point of view that I was not asked at all to do mm-hmm. neither for good, neither for bad publicity mm-hmm. of Zoom. But how did you get that, the link between Zoom and psychodrama? How and when did you get that?
Okay, I'll tell you that. So that was in November 2017. I am a psychodrama trainer, and mm-hmm. And I live in North Texas in Dallas area, and Dallas area is very, very large area, and my trainees to come to my office, some of them have to drive 2-3 hours, even if they uh-huh. live in this area. And so in 2017, I started offering special classes for didactic, psychodrama didactic for advanced trainees. And we were meeting just for 2 hours. And that is when I decided to try, what if we meet via Zoom? Because it is didactic, no action, right? I would teach them history, philosophy, ethics. So we started, and I just started experimenting, suggesting some warm up, suggesting some demonstration, and I realized, and my trainees realized, that it worked. So that is how it started. Over time, I started offering a training workshops, at least at first 2 hours, then 2 hours and a half, 3 hours longer. And I started inviting also people from other locations and international participants. Mm-hmm. And it became very, very exciting, realizing that this is about international sociometry, that this is about what Dr. Moreno, who is right there listening to us, I can see him on the wall, and Zirka. Dr. Moreno, this was his dream, international sociometry, people from around the world to be able to get together, to work together. So it was like opening many, many windows. Zoom was, every time when people were coming, it was exactly like opening a window to somebody in Portugal, somebody in Iraq, somebody in Mexico, somebody in Russia, somebody in Bulgaria, and working together. So it became very, very exciting.
Okay. I have no idea how much time it took for us to arrive at this point, but what I'm going to suggest is that we stop again, and we finished another video with that before people go out and look for other videos. We stop here. This is my suggestion. Do you agree, doctor? I can't hear you. Yes, Zerka told me yes. Okay.
She said yes, okay.